It is truly my pleasure to welcome to Malta so many international educators from diverse fields in the education sector. Let me begin by commending Ken Brian, President of the Commonwealth Council for Educational Administration and Management, and Professor Christopher Bezzina from the University of Malta for bringing for the very first time this important conference in the Maltese Islands. And thank you, Dr. Kushkiri, for being so passionate about this conference, which you have informed me about. And I'm really pleased that really I changed my travel plans to later in the afternoon to be with you. I'm sure that this conference will create the opportunity to share your experiences, to explore the latest research about educational leadership, and to discover new strategies to your work. Coming together from diverse cultures and regions to work in synergy as a family of nations within the Commonwealth gives a clear message of the importance that should be given to education and empowerment. I am convinced that there is so much to share amongst you and that there is so much to learn from each other. I'm also convinced that our Maltese educators have a lot to say about the ongoing process of educational reform in my country. Even though we have, for many decades, been working to ensure that our national educational system is an inclusive one, more student-oriented and more focused on the professional aspirations of our educators. And we managed to overcome many challenges over time to reach our objectives. However, we do not sit on our laurels. We continue to monitor and continue to introduce innovative measures so as to keep streamlining inclusivity in our system. For these reasons and more, I believe that the Maltese Islands will provide the perfect setting for your deliberations. As we all know, our societies are changing rapidly, and education has to respond to the many concerns and challenges of the 21st century. Educators are leaders for change. Educators are central to our communities and to our societies. Educators are key to create awareness about social justice and can provide the practical means to effectively empower our children, our young people, and our communities with the necessary skills to have the resilience that is necessary to overcome the challenges of life. In this context, let me quote the words of the British philosopher Herbert Spencer, who said that the great aim of education is not simply knowledge, but action. In order to achieve the most effective action, I believe that educators must be empowered and given the necessary resources to implement reforms which meet the challenges and demands of our globalized world. In practical terms, empowerment is key to the creation of leadership for our teachers who have been given the opportunity to an ongoing system of self and professional development. This is essential because teachers are the ones who work in the closest contact with students. Teachers are therefore well placed to develop the appropriate education strategies to ensure that they can give the best educational experience to all the children and young people under their care. A 2016 survey carried out by the Times Educational Supplement in the United Kingdom indicated that 8 out of 10 teachers globally do not feel that their profession is sufficiently valued by society. Furthermore, this same survey states that 90% of school leaders, that is the top management of our education institutions, feel that teaching is undervalued. Therefore, the empowerment of our educators must be part of a larger transformation within our respective societies. We must work to restore the dignity of the teaching profession. As the daughter of an educator myself, I have had first-hand experience of the fact that being a teacher is not simply a job. It is a vocation, a commitment towards the intellectual development and the holistic well-being of all the members of our societies. In this context, I would like to take the opportunity to encourage our governments and our universities to effectively invest in the professional development of our educators. The empowerment of our educators is a crucial component of the social empowerment strategies that must be put in place to create a constructive educational system in our countries. Teachers must be encouraged to regain their sense of pride and self-worth, while also being able to apply their creative energy to seek their constant and consistent improvement. A study which explains this issue, entitled Towards an Evolving Conceptualization of Instructional Leadership as Leadership for Learning, which was published earlier this year by the Journal of Educational Administration, presents a comprehensive review of 25 years of quantitative instructional leadership research. The outcomes of this impressive study reveal that two of the most important factors which motivate the instructional leadership abilities of educators are teachers' satisfaction and teachers' commitment. Therefore, a practical approach to encourage teachers to develop their full potential is by focusing on the sources of satisfaction and commitment, which empower our educators to pursue opportunities for leadership and to ensure that they are safeguarded at a national and professional level. For this reason, I believe that it is essential for the voices of our teachers to be shared. Our political authorities and policymakers must respond to the first-hand experiences of educators and their concerns. Teachers' aspirations must be given the consideration that they deserve in the formulation and implementation of the relevant legislation and policies. This can be achieved most successfully by establishing a professional culture which highlights the importance of value-centered leadership. I believe that to provide appropriate and effective education across our societies, we must emphasize the need for ongoing professional development and the empowerment of our educators. In this way, I am convinced that we will be better equipped to transform our Commonwealth of Nations into a global role model for educational leadership and the holistic well-being of our educators and their students. Moreover, I am confident that this necessary transformation can only be achieved by prioritizing an inclusive and multicultural education, which is built upon the universal human rights and fundamental freedoms. Educators are the most important catalysts to create such an inclusive, rights-based, and respectful educational system. This is why effective leadership for teachers must be rooted in the values of inclusion, equity, and equality. Each one of these values has been identified explicitly as a critical objective for teacher empowerment by the Commonwealth Ministers of Education. I would like to encourage you, as educators from diverse fields in the educational sector, to continue to seek opportunities to develop your own capacity to achieve these goals in your careers and professional development. In this way, you will also be making a practical contribution towards the commitment made by all of our countries to achieve the mandate of the United Nations Agenda 2030 and its Sustainable Development Goals. In particular, SDG number 4 commits all of our countries to achieve inclusive and sustainable education by 2030. In this way, we will be providing an effective pathway to empower our citizens, but also our educators. On concluding, let me share with you the inspiring words of the former Secretary General of the United Nations, Kofi Annan, who was himself a citizen of the Commonwealth. Kofi Annan said, that knowledge is power. Information is liberating. Education is the premise of progress in every society, in every family. I am convinced that in your capacity as teachers and educators, you will be able to achieve the necessary progress in the education sector of our countries, our regions, and our entire Commonwealth of Nations. I have learned from my own experience as a politician for many decades that trust and respect are essential values for effective and genuine leadership. In my opinion, if you embrace trust and respect as an intrinsic part of your work with students, you will be ensuring that our communities, our Commonwealth of Nations, and our entire world will be empowered to overcome the challenges of the present and the future, as it will translate into the necessary skills for resilience. Thank you for your attention, and I look forward to exploring the outcomes of this important conference. Thank you.